And it started when somebody asked us about a documentary about doping and cycling and could we show if it worked. We came to the conclusion that this was a medicine people were using for the disease slow cycling. If you look at the literature and you look at the newspapers, everyone seems to know EPO works. It makes you cycle really, really fast. We were unsure about how well it worked and how many side effects or potential markers for side effects occurred.
What we wanted to do in the EPO study is to look at the effects of EPO on well-trained cyclists. Of course, we couldn't include professional cyclists because they would be in violation of the doping rules. So we had to find well-trained cyclists that are not part of a union that has doping rules. So if a subject has a dosing day, he comes to CHDR, and in the laboratory we determine different blood values, and based on that we prepare the syringe of EPO or placebo. And when this is ready, it goes back to the subject again, and the physician injects the EPO or placebo into the abdomen, where it's absorbed by the body and can do its effect. After we have determined that the subject is doing fine and is feeling well, he's discharged and he can go home.
EPO, erythropoietin, does very little else than increasing the number of red blood cells that goes through your circulation. So the amount of oxygen that can be transported by your blood per volume is bigger.
We included 48 well-trained subjects and all these subjects had the same measurements. And in total, we did 300 maximal exercise tests. We did 100 submaximal exercise tests in the course of 3 months. And in that period, we also collected about 10 liters of blood, 250 liters of urine, and we placed about 400 syringes of EPO or placebo.
So our expectations are that the effect is not so big, but that's totally different from the expectations of all the other people who've been using it.
At the end of the study, we performed also a road race, and for that we went to the south of France. We first did a cycling tour of 120 kilometers, and at the end of that we reached the base of the Mont Ventoux and did a race up the finish line and looked at the results of the race time of all the subjects.
If we provide better scientific evidence for doping, in many ways against doping, if it doesn't work, then people will stop using these substances because it's actually dangerous and it doesn't do much good.